nuevos cañones de España.
¿En serio? ¡Qué buena noticia!
Sí, el puerto será inexpugnable.
No uses esa palabra. Recuerda a Morgan y Cortovelo.
¡Es mío! ¡No escapará!
El gobernador traerá nuevos cañones de España.
¡Quieto!
¡De eso nada!
Oh! ¡Intenta despistarnos!
Un poco imposible.
Thank you.
¡Permanece o muere! ¡No destaco por mi paciencia! ¡Tú, date
por vencido! ¡Quieto!
¡Alto!
Pronto estarás criando malvas.
No tengo nada que ver con esto.
Sorry about the swift exit. Bit of a misunderstanding.
One heaped upon another.
Oh, Jesus. I'm sorry, mate. This is my doing. I'm only trying to keep these Spanish eyes off me.
Oh, it's no bother. Regrettably, the soldiers confiscated my sugar. Oh, and your dispatches.
Damn! And where have they gone?
Haven't the foggiest idea, I'm afraid. I suspect those chaps might, but my Spanish is wee mal dad, so I'd rather not ask.
Shit! All right, come on, let's follow them and recover my maps.
And my sugar?
What, in my drawers? We'll see what happens.
You don't mind me tagging along, do you?
Not if you keep quiet and stay out of sight.
Sola aquí. ¿Cómo podría aliviar mi
Pull it!
I believe I'm getting the hang of this!
Quiet!
I fear they're onto us!
Hang back.
Perhaps we should split up to confuse them.
Best idea you've had today.
De
El omne vinum vivimus. Caulis nostra sunt loca unde exinerum est.
Buenos dias, senores. You're late.
Yes, sir. Si, we are very sorry. Our captain delayed us.
This would be Captain Mendoza.
Yes, sir. He's very excited to meet you. Only he must be present for a hanging.
Señor.
Hanging?
I know a good hanging.
Yes, sir. Very nice. If we hear the bell, we may go, if you like.
I'd love to. Especially if Captain Mendoza's pulling the trap.
Man owes me money for the slaves I sold him.
Of course, sir. Captain Mendoza is happy to pay you. We have goods to sell, sugars and such.
Excellent.
Estás jugando a un juego mortal. Estás jugando a un juego mortal.
Alto ahí.
Thank you.
How long will this hanging take, man? I don't mean to hang about all day for the captain.
Quick as anything, sir. Captain Mendoza needs only to hang the man, then he will deliver your payment.
I don't want reales, mind. I want goods. Things I can sell. Tobacco, rum, sugar.
Si, we have much fine sugar. Great, we took off a fat Englishman last night.
Englishman?
Sugar from Barbados. Very fine. We hold it in the casino after the man started the fight last night. He ran, left his sugar behind. Very fine.
Well, that's a start. Shall I accompany him to the Castillo?
No, sir. Captain Mendoza will have it sent to you, I believe. You will see.
Good Lord. Is that big brute your Captain Mendoza?
No, sir. He is El Tiburón. El Tiburón, Governor Torres's man.
Creo que puedo darle.
Thank you.
¡Maldita sea!
Creo que puedo darle. ¡Un blanco claro!
¡Eh! ¿A dónde te crees que vas?
¡Tú! ¡Detente! ¡Vaya conmigo! ¡Celebrémoslo! ¡Arriba, arriba! ¡Levántate! ¡Por el oro y la riqueza! ¡Aunque hoy ando bien cernido!
Sorry about the sugar. I've only one pair of hands.
Oh, it's no great loss. I've got plenty of cargo here to make a profit on my trip.
Will you stay here long?
For a few weeks, yes. Then back to Barbados, to the tedium of domesticity.
Don't settle for tedium. Sail for Nassau. Live life as you see fit.
Haven't I heard that Nassau is crawling with pirates? Seems a very tawdry place.
Not tawdry, liberated.
Oh, God. That would be an adventure. But no. No, I'm a husband and a father. I have responsibilities. Life can't be all pleasure and distraction, Duncan.
Hey, our bonnet. The name's Edward, in truth. Duncan's only a handle.
Ah. Secret name for your secret meeting with the governor.
The governor, right. I think I've kept him waiting long enough.
forma de pensar no es adecuada para un caballo. Hay una carga de metal separada en el puerto esperando que la descargue, pero tendría que hacer sitio en el patio.
Buenos días. Mr. Duncan Walpole of England to see the governor. I believe he is expecting me.
Sí, señor Walpole. Entre, por favor. ¿Ese es el hombre? ¿El... cómo lo llamabas? ¿Asesino?
Sí, Duncan Walpole. Debería haber llegado hace muchos días.
No me gusta que los extranjeros se paseen por nuestra ciudad. No me fío de ellos.
Cállate. El gobernador tiene invitados. Todos franceses e ingleses.
Parece un hombre rudo. Le suponía un aspecto más respetable.
Llévame ese en alta mar. Se... vente con él.
You've got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan, so handle them with care.
If I had eight, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like, get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried nine on his person. They were a boon in battle, but hindered his ability to swim. Sadly.
Quite. I still kick, yes?
I long for a day where one firearm carries four bullets, and not the opposite.
I have a friend in England you may like to meet, Julian. James Puckle. He's working on something extraordinary.
Magnifique.
Duncan, where are your wrist blades? I've never seen an assassin so ill-equipped.
Ah, damaged, sadly, beyond all repair.
Uh-huh. Have your choice.
Where did you find all these?
I did not find them. I took them. These are souvenirs. Two blades, as is the custom, oui?
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Well,
You must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action.
Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see? Situation is well suited to your skills.
Have a go. A blade in a crowd is always the simplest. Nothing grandiose, just quick and clean.
Show us another technique.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think? God, that's the spirit! Secrecy. The advantage of surprise cannot be overstated, isn't that so? Especially around a blind corner.
¿Qué hice para molestar?
God blind me, that's a clever trick.
Your aerial kills have a poetic beauty, despite their conspicuous quality. Would you show us? Magnifique. Is it also possible to deliver a killing blow at high speed?
Mon Dieu, such a powerful strike.
Fascinating.
The assassins have trained you well, Duncan. You chose a perfect time to leave them behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying the assassins is never good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados. Anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts.
And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates. It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with that kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres! Mr. Duncan Walpole has arrived.
Convened at last, and in such continental company. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look up on these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For two decades now, I have endeavored to locate this Observatory. A place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Only imagine what it would mean to have such a power. With this device, there would be no secrets among men. No lies, no trickery. Only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
We will soon. For in our custody is the one man who does. A man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Indeed they will. But thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink. Let us find the observatory together. For with its power, kings will fall, clergy will cower, and the hearts and minds of the world will be ours. Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which we will discuss further schemes.
I look forward to it.
Excelente. Meet me down at the docks first thing tomorrow morning.
Governor Torres requests your presence at the docks near the Castillo. First thing tomorrow morning.
Duncan.
Good morning, Duncan. Just over here.
Edward! Hello, Edward!
Such a fuss over one man. Is the observatory really such a grand prize?
See. Singula. The observatory was a tool built by the precursor race. Its worth is without measure.
Precursor race? I see.
One of your early letters mentioned the desire to kill the Mayan mentor, Atabai. Were you able to carry out this contract before coming?
I was not, no. Too many complications along the way.
A pity. The maps you delivered with the blood vial will see that job first.
Aye. That's the idea.
I don't like this route, Torres. We're exposed. Something is wrong. Stay close, Grandmaster.
I feel it too. Do not let them get their hands on the sage, at whatever cost.
Assassins! Above! They're on the rooftop!
Watch the streets and alleys. They could be anywhere.
You're a nimble one, I'll give you that. Hang back and make this easy on both of us, mate. Kneecap you.
Well done, Lapdog.
Quiet!
We'll see him to the prisons, Grandmaster.
Double the watch.
Well, I'll be buggered. What an active day we've had, gents.
See, si, beset on all sides by our enemies. We must be more cautious.
I do wish I could remain to see our drama done, but I must avail myself of these winds and sail for England.
By all means, Captain, speed and fortune to you.
With luck, I'll return myself a governor. And with my idiot king's blessing, no less. Adios.
As for you, Mr. Walpole, I consider this the first payment in a long-term investment. Gracias.
Obliged.
I would like you to be present for the interrogation tomorrow. Call around noon.
Yes, sir. Thank you.